I'm Nathan, and we're gonna do projects 1 and 2! Let's get straight to it! Alright, let's do project 1. The first thing you need is the gear motor. Which way it spins affects which way the positive and negative output will be. We're putting it from A5 to C5. Then next we need a 2-snap wire. This is a piece that connects 2 points. Then we need a 4-snap wire. This is a piece that connects 4 points instead of 2. And we need to put it from A2 to A5. Connecting to the 2-snap wire to the gear motor. So next we need a 3-snap wire. This is bigger than the 2, but smaller than the 4. It can connect 3 points. Let's put at C1 to C3. Then let's place another 3-snap from C3 to C5. Next we get M4. This is a shaded pole motor, meaning which direction the input is, the fan will spin. So if the input is here, it'll spin that way. If the input is there, it'll spin that way. Get? Now let's place it from A1 to C1. Next is Melody IC. Remember positive and negative. But also, if you're wondering what IC means, it means integrated circuit. Now let's place it on A3 to C3. Positive, negative. Now let's get D10. If the input is here, the output will be here. It goes in, it circles, but it can't go out there. So it goes back and it goes out there. If it's here, it goes in, circles, but it can't go out there, so it goes back through there. Now let's place it. Now we're done. Awesome. All right, puzzle's complete. Now that we've got the circuit completed, let's spin the crank arm. Spin it to the right, like a clock. Be warned that these are very delicate parts, so be nice. Once you spin it correctly, you should see a red light and you should instantly be teleported to 7-Eleven. Are you ready to get some Slurpees? Let's do this.
We're here. Might as well get a Slurpee. Oh, here it is. Bye.
We just did demo part 1. Now let's do demo part 2. Let's go to project 2, crank charger. We're gonna start with B4. Now we're gonna put it on A4 to C4. Now we're gonna get M6, the meter. Now let's place it from A2 to C2. Now we're gonna get the gear motor. Now let's place it from B6 to D6. These are 3-snap wires. They can connect 3 points. Let's place them from the meter going to the positive port. And then let's place the second one going to the negative point. So this is a one piece. This is used if you're trying to connect multiple points that are at multiple levels. So let's place it down at D4. Okay. Now we have a D10, a multicolored diode. This is D8, a multicolored diode. Make sure you put it on the positive side of the circuit. We already charged the battery, so that's why it's lighting up. Next is a 2-snap wire. This can connect 2 points. Let's put it at the negative side of the battery to the positive side of D10. So we have this black jumper wire. So this is kind of like a string. So you can connect 2 points with it. Let's put it from the gear motor to the input port of the battery. That charges the battery. Oh, look, project's complete. Good job. Now that it's complete, let me show you how this works. So, you know when we put the meter in? Make sure that it's set at the 5-volt setting because that's required for today's circuit. Now, this is a 3.6-volt battery, and on the meter, you should read 3.6 volts when it's fully charged. If it's not fully charged, spin this clockwise and D10 should light up, indicating that you're charging the battery and it's a full circuit. But if you spin it counterclockwise, you get nothing. Now, we have a 3.6 volt on the meter. But what if this wasn't charged? We need some way to charge this. We have this perfectly good gear motor, but let me explain what happens. If you spin it counterclockwise, nothing will happen because the D10 diode will block it. So if you spin it clockwise, the yellow light D10 will turn on, indicating that you're triple charging the battery. Now time to trickle charge our battery. You see these plants behind me? You should watch our hydroponic videos if you like this one. See you later. Bye.